Welcome to this video on how to create a library in SharePoint 2013. A library is a place to collect and manage files. This video demonstrates how to create several types of libraries and reviews their column and view settings. We'll also mention other types of SharePoint libraries. There are a couple of important notes about terminology. First, SharePoint considers a library to be a specialized list that contains files rather than items. You will occasionally see a library called a list and files called items. Second, SharePoint is now using the apps model that you're probably familiar with. So you will also run across instances where a library is called an app. Here's a typical document library that contains files such as Word documents, Excel spreadsheets, PowerPoint presentations, and PDFs. Whenever a SharePoint site is created, a document library is created by default. But you may need additional document libraries if you have a lot of documents, if you want to control access to some documents through SharePoint permissions, or if you want to have different library settings, such as checkout or versioning, for some documents. To create a document library, click the Settings gear, then Add an app. The Your Apps page appears. The Noteworthy section lists the most popular apps, and that's where you'll find the document library. Click its icon. If you're in a hurry, you can simply enter a name and click Create. But we'll take a quick look at the advanced options. First, give the library a name. Because this name is also used in the library's address or URL, we are keeping the name short and not using spaces or special characters. Once the library is created, we can change its name to make it more descriptive. Add a description and choose to create a version every time a file is edited. Versioning is covered in more detail in the versioning video. When you use the new document command in a library, SharePoint opens a blank file of the type defined in the document template. Here, the default template is a blank Microsoft Word document. You can change this setting so a blank file from an earlier version of Word or another Microsoft application is opened instead. It is generally best to leave the default of Microsoft Word unless you are certain all new files should be presentations, spreadsheets, or another of these applications. Do not use any of the options for web pages. Click Create to create the document library. The new document library contains a default view of all documents. And here are the columns that are automatically shown in a new document library. Click the Files tab and New Document to confirm which template is being used for a new file. In the Open Document dialog, note the .dotx extension, which is a Word template, and click OK. A blank Word document opens, so you know the correct template is being used. Close the document. Click the Library tab and Library Settings. Now, change the library name to something more readable. Click List Name, Description, and Navigation Settings, and change the name to Document Library with Versioning. If you want the library to appear in the Quick Launch area of the left column, click Yes. This option is available on the team sites of Inside NCDOT and Connect NCDOT. Click Save to store your changes. In the Settings page, note that the name has changed, but the URL has not. Scroll down to see the automatically created columns that are available for your use. The Title column is a critical column. While it can be renamed, it cannot be deleted. It is also used in search results. You'll also see the automatically created views. In this case, it's only the default view of all documents. Click the library name in the breadcrumb to return to the library. And here's the link to the library in the Quick Launch. An asset library is the best place to store audio and video files. It's also the place to store images that are used on web pages, such as headers, logos, or background images. A default site assets library is created, but you can also create a new asset library if needed. To do this, click the Settings gear, then Add an app. You can scroll through the Your Apps pages to find the library you need, but the asset library is generally not on the first page, so it's easier to search for the term asset and use those results. Click the asset library icon and go to the Advanced Options again. Name the library. Add a description and skip versioning. Click Create. The default view is thumbnails, and these are the columns shown by default. An additional view of all assets is created with these columns. Click the Library tab and Library Settings. To change the library name, click List Name, Description, and Navigation Settings, and enter Asset Library. Click Save. Here's the new name and old URL on the settings page. Here are the columns that are available in an asset library. As before, the title column can be renamed, but cannot be deleted. And here are the automatically created views. Scroll up and click the breadcrumb to return to the library. A picture library should only contain images used in slideshows. You can use the default picture library or create a new picture library if needed. Click the Settings gear, then Add an app. You'll find the picture library close to the top of the Your Apps page. Click its icon. Skip the advanced options since they are the same as we've seen before. Name the library. When you click Create to create the library, you'll go to the Site Contents page rather than the library itself because you skipped the advanced options. Review the Site Contents page and note that the new libraries have a green icon for New. Click Slideshow Lib to go to the picture library. The library's default view is thumbnails and has these columns. There is an additional view for all pictures which has these columns. A third view of slides has no columns. Once the picture library contains images, the slides view shows the full-size image with standard slideshow controls. Click the Library tab and Library Settings. Click List Name, Description, and Navigation Settings to change the name to Slideshow Library. Because we couldn't enter a description earlier, let's enter one here. Click Save. And here are the available columns and available views. Let's quickly cover a couple of additional SharePoint libraries. An images library is the best place to store photographs that are important as content. For example, you might need to refer to individual photographs of construction sites, and you'd want those photos to be listed in search results. An images library is created by default, but you cannot create additional images libraries. A page is SharePoint terminology for a web page. It's a file that ends in .aspx and is stored in the page's library. SharePoint automatically places any page that you create in the appropriate library. The pages library is created by default, but you cannot create additional pages libraries. Please do not use the Site Pages Library, the Slide Library, or the Wiki Page Library. There are two libraries reserved for use by web services, the Data Connection Library and the Form Library. In this video, we've examined how to create document, asset, and picture libraries and briefly reviewed other types of SharePoint libraries. There is a companion video that describes additional library and list settings, so you have many options for customization. We encourage you to check out our other SharePoint videos, as well as the reference and training materials on the SharePoint Help site. On Connect NCDOT, there is a link to help on every page. Go to the main help page and click SharePoint Help to see the SharePoint Help information. On Inside NCDOT, there is a link to the help site in the header and footer of every page. Those links also take you to the SharePoint help site. For information on upcoming SharePoint classes, log in to Beacon and check the LMS training calendar, or contact the PC training group. Thanks for watching.